I'm Rabbi Sarah Hurwitz, co-founder and president of Yeshivat Maharat, and this morning I want to talk about an abundance of love. Our Torah is filled with love. We're told, "Lelechet b'kol derachav olahava oto," walk in God's ways and love God. We're told to love ourselves, love our neighbors, love the orphan, the widow, the stranger. And yet I've always associated love with Christianity. And in fact, a few years ago, I had the opportunity to travel to Beit Jamal, a monastery in Israel, with the Hartman Fellowship. And we met nuns who had taken on a vow of silence. Now, two of them were given permission to speak to our group. And they told us about their ethic of love and how they did so siloed away from the world. And as I listened to their message, I felt sad that they weren't able to integrate this message out into the world. And I was thinking that in Judaism, love only lives when it's partnered with justice, with getting out and being there for others. When you think about Bereshit, it's a book of developing relationship. Rachel loves Yaakov, Yosef is learning to love his brothers, and yet, It's stories that also often are divisive. It's not until we get to the book of Devarim where we're introduced to tzedek and justice intertwined with love. We should love God, but God also feeds the strangers or tells us to feed the strangers because we were once strangers in Egypt. That's when love really comes alive. We cannot remain behind a wall. The Gemara in Baba Batra explains that we shall not live in a walled off, gated community. We cannot throw away the key. We must break open the walls and we must get out into the world and live close to the problems and the evils of what's happening out there. In fact, my chavrusa, Rabbi Shoshana Conover from Hartman, introduced me to a episode in Radiolab of a woman who had a very loud beating heart. In fact, it was so loud that it kept her up at night. She had to have open heart surgery to try to fix the problem. And during the episode, she put the microphone up to her heart and everybody heard her heart beating and several people in the audience fainted. The message was that when we open ourselves to people's beating hearts, when we can hear what's happening, we have a visceral reaction. We have to embrace that reaction and go out into the world and listen to people's hearts. There's a Hasidic tale about a question of why it says, al levavacha, that we should put the words on our heart, al levavacha, and not inside our hearts. And the answer is that the words live outside of us until we can break open our hearts, until we look out and we feel sadness and devastation, so much so that we can open ourselves up to fixing the world and allow love to animate us and to get us out into the world and fix it. It's marrying the concept of love and tzedek, ahava and tzedek, love and justice, that allows us to be present in the world. And this is a message I hold dear. At Yeshivat Maharat, I love Torah, I love learning Torah, and I could have continued to do so hidden away in the Beit Midrash, but that's not enough. I wanted to take the Torah that I love and share it with the world, combine love with justice, with tzedek, and take all that I hold dear and spread it out into the world, spread the light and the love. It's when we get proximate, when we open our hearts to joy and difficulties and love and laughter, that's when real tzedek emanates into our lives.